Hi guys, it's Alexis.
And I'm Gaurav.
And we're bringing you the latest from the world of cricket. MS Dhoni hit his highest score in the Indian T20 League but ended up on the losing side as Chennai fell short by 4 runs in their chase against Punjab. Facing a target of 198 to win, Chennai kept the big hits going with Dhoni's partnership with Raidu, who got run out on 49.
Now earlier, a blistering knock of 63 of 33 by Chris Gayle and a solid start by KL Rahul got Punjab going, but they had a relatively tepid finish. Gayle, Rahul and Yuvraj got out to soft dismissals, enabling the Chennai bowlers to come back into the game. Punjab's pacers, on the other hand, went for runs, while their spinner Mujib was given only 3 overs despite a neat show.
In the earlier game, 10 huge sixes and the highest score in the IPL so far. Sanju Samson's 92 off just 45 balls gave Rajasthan their second win of the season as they beat the Royal Challengers Bangalore by 19 runs. In fact, Samson's 10 sixes were the second most in any sub-100 innings in the IPL.
And in reply, RCB could only post 198 for 6 as captain Virat Kohli's 57 went in vain. Mandeep Singh and Washington Sundar's late flourish was unable to overhaul the huge target. Umesh, who had a good first couple of games, had an off day as his 27 runs of the last over was the second most expensive ever in the 20th over in IPL.
Moving on now, skipper Dinesh Karthik will face a big test when Kolkata lock horns with a resurgent Delhi led by former KKR skipper Gautam Gambhir in the much-anticipated clash. Kolkata had made a winning start to their campaign against Bangalore, but successive defeats to Chennai and Hyderabad in the next 2 matches have put them in a spot of bother.
Sunil Narain could be the key for Kolkata with 20 wickets from 11 innings against Delhi, his second best against IPL teams. Delhi have a poor head-to-head record of 8-12 against Kolkata, but having Gambhir as captain, who was with KKR since 2011, would make the atmosphere quite interesting at the Eden.
On the international scene now, Aaron Finch has said he's game to captain Australia once again should the selectors come calling. With the suspensions of David Warner and Stephen Smith, the team not only has to find new personnel but also appoint new leaders. Tim Payne, barely into a comeback in international cricket, became Australia's 46th test captain last month.
Finch said he would be keen to take up the job but hadn't thought about it right now. He added it was a difficult time and some changes are expected to be made in the next couple of months with the England ODIs and the tests against Pakistan. But if the opportunity came up, he'd love to take it, but it wasn't something he'd thought about.
Finch had been appointed Australia's full-time T20 captain in 2014, but after 6 matches on the job and with a 2016 World T20 on the horizon, Cricket Australia decided to have one captain for all 3 formats and gave the reins to Stephen Smith.